Comenius recommended that his students first learn the vestibulum in their own languages. So what I'm going to do here is read it through firstly just in English, so that the whole vestibulum, so you can get an idea of its contents before you attack it in the bilingual version or in the Latin-only version and the various tests that I've made for it. So here we go, chapter 1. The accidents of things. God is eternal. The world is temporary. An angel is immortal. Man is mortal. The body is visible. The spirit invisible. The soul likewise. Heaven is the highest. The air is in the middle. The earth is the lowest. A cloud is far away. A mist nearby. A place is great or small. A time is long or short. A courtyard is broad or narrow. A house is large or cramped. Mountains are high. Valleys are deep. Hillocks are raised up. A cottage is low, a tower high. A fir tree is tall. A river is shallow or deep. A thread is slender. A rope is thick. A reed is hollow. And wood is solid. A hole is void or empty. A chimney is full of smoke. A line is straight or curved. An outside or a surface is rough or smooth. A weight heavy or light. A number even or odd. A globe is round. A pillar is rounded. A table is square. X, the letter X, has the shape of a cross. A peacock is beautiful. An ape is ugly or deformed. Colors. Chalk is white. A blackboard is black. Vermilion is red. Brimstone is pale yellow. Grass is green. The sky is blue. Glass is translucent. A plank is opaque or dusky. Water is troubled or clear. Savors. Honey is sweet, and so is sugar. Gall is bitter. Vinegar is tart. Salt is briny. Pepper is sharp. An unripe apple is sour or unpleasant, acerbic. Smelling or smells. A smell is sweet. A stink is disgusting. Other qualities. Clay is moist, dust is dry, bones are hard, flesh is soft, ice is slippery or ice is brittle. A live coal is warm and glowing, a dead coal is cold and black. We go about clothed, the Indians naked. A unicorn is a fierce animal, a cow is gentle, a lion cruel, sheep quiet, a guest is merry. A place is pleasant. Friendship is pleasant. Good news is joyful. All these are welcome and acceptable. A place is comfortable or uncomfortable. Time is seasonable or unseasonable. An instrument is fit or unfit for purpose. A person agreeable or disagreeable. A thing is necessary or it is superfluous. The use of a thing is necessary or it is hurtful. One thing is similar or dissimilar to another. A wood or a forest is thick or thin. A field is fruitful or barren. A motion is fast or slow. A runner is fast or slow. A workman is energetic or lazy. A hatchet or an axe is sharp or blunt. Meat is raw, or food is raw, or boiled. A speech is merry or serious. A history is certain or doubtful. A testimony, or a witnessing, is true or false. Comparatives. The first is educated, the second is more educated, the third is most educated. Irregular comparisons. A bull is big, a camel is bigger, an elephant is the biggest. A sparrow is small. A titmouse is smaller. A wren is the smallest. Ale is good, med is better, wine is the best. A lizard is bad, a viper worse, and an ape is the worst. Denominatives, a ducat of gold, a dollar of silver, a kettle of copper, a pot of tin, a hammer of iron, a bench of wood, and a wall of stone. Chapter 2. Of the actions and passions of things. For the honour of the Creator, all creatures do their duty. The actions of heavenly creatures. Angels celebrate him. The sun shines, the moon is bright, the stars twinkle. The day begins in the morning, the night at evening. Of elements. Elements nourish us. Fire burns, a flame flashes, a spark glows, thunder thunders, the wind blows, the rain rains, snow snows. Water runs on the level and it flows out of a vase. It bubbles or leaps out of a fountain and is drawn out of a well. Of plants, a herb grows, a leaf is green, a flower flowers or blossoms, the fruit ripens. So you may crop it, bend the branch, whether they be pears or plums or cherries. A nut contains a kernel, a rose smells good. A nettle stings, literally it burns. Of living creatures, a stone lies, a tree stands up, a living creature moves itself, a bird flies, a fish swims, a four-footed animal moves, a serpent creeps, a worm crawls, a deer runs, a horse neighs, an ox lows, a lamb bleats, a hog grunts, a bear murmurs, a wolf howls. A dog barks, a ram butts, and a wild animal tears into pieces. A hare runs away. A fox changes his hair. A cat catches mice. A hen lays eggs. A goose eats oats. Worms gnaw at fat things. Lice bite the skin, and also gnats and bedbugs. An ant is hardworking. A spider is crafty or clever. Bees prick with a sting, and whatever lives is lively. Of man, we do various things with our body and mind. The head is filled with the brain, it is covered with hair, except the face. No body part is given in vain, for we see with our eyes, we empty filth by the nose, the forehead has wrinkles, the ears hear, the nostrils smell. The tongue tastes how things smell, we chew with the teeth. The stomach digests, the bowels cast out. The liver makes blood and sends it through the veins. The heart beats, the lungs breathe. The lips are about the mouth, a beard adorns the chin. Women are beardless. We carry with the shoulders, we embrace with the arms, we labor with the hands. The left holds and the right does a work. We handle with the palm, we hit with the fist, we hold with the hollow of the hand. We straighten things with the fingers, we scratch and scrape with the nails. The belly is under the chest, the sides are under the armpits, the ribs are below these. The back has shoulder blades above and below the loins. We sit on the buttocks and we walk with the feet. Of the mind. The mind always thinks of something. Also dreams in a dream, and the understanding understands, the reason reasons, and the memory remembers. And if it has forgotten something, it remembers it. The will desires that which is good. It shuns evil, but is often deceived. It rejoices and is sad. A careless man regards for nothing. A man that is safe fears nothing. Someone that is full of energy works. Someone that is tired rests. Watching makes one tired. Sleep refreshes. When you have slept for 7 hours and awaken, wake up the others. Regarding the diseased, somebody that is fasting wants food. Someone that is full loathes food. Someone that is fussy chooses. Someone one that is sound is in good health. A sick man is sick. Someone who is in pain complains. Diseases without pain are dangerous and, for the most part, deadly. A fever comes back by fits. Apoplexy, a stroke, kills suddenly. A scab causes an itch. An ulcer abounds with corrupt blood. A new wound is healed. Whatever is rotten stinks. A strong man can carry much. Someone who is weak can carry little, can suffer little. Someone that is blind does not see. Someone that is deaf does not hear. Someone that is dumb does not speak. No man lacks the sense of touch except for someone who is paralyzed. A lame person limps. Something is lacking for the maimed. Regarding workmen, of workmen, a farmer ploughs, he sows in the spring, he harvests in the summer. In autumn he gathers the vines, the grapes. In winter he threshes in the barn. A gardener plants a garden. A miller grinds corn in the mill. A baker bakes bread out of flour in an oven. A shepherd feeds his flock. He cuts hay in the meadow. He makes cheeses out of milk. A butcher kills beasts. A huntsman hunts wild beasts. A fowler catches birds. A fisherman fishes. A cook prepares food. He boils in a pot. He roasts on spits. He fries it in butter. He broils on the grill. We season our dishes with spices. We put drink in a cellar. Wine is made of grapes. Ale is drawn out of a barrel. A carter harnesses his horses and greases the wheels. And he goes suddenly, but sticks in the mud when he carries burdens in a cart or a dray. A sailor sails in a ship. A pilot guides it in. Rowers row it. We wade through rivers, or use boats, or make little or small bridges. A traveller goes along a path and takes care lest he wander and falls into a hole. He goes backwards where he cannot go forwards. A merchant deals in merchandise. He fears loss and seeks gain. Money is carried in a purse, because with money we pay for those things which we owe. We buy or sell dear or cheap. Monies are various kinds. Each one has its own value. The spinner spins out of hemp. A weaver weaves linen, a web of threads. A clothier makes clothes out of wool. A tailor measures clothes. A shoemaker sews shoes out of leather. And a skinner leather coats out of skins. A rope maker twists rope. A potter makes jugs. A joiner glues his desks. A smith beats. He beats on an anvil. A carpenter hews with an axe and builds a building. He lays a foundation and he erects walls. He covers it with a roof. A weak building is not strong and is held up with props, lest it fall down. Impersonal verbs. If it's allowed, then it's lawful. Or if you like doing it, then it's lawful. If work bothers you, let it shame you. And it's necessary that you be ashamed to sin. For a young person, silence is fitting. If work tires you, then you should go. If sitting tires you, then you should go out for a walk. Chapter 3. Adverbs. The circumstances of things. Who calls me? I. Is that you? Who is there then? Paul. Let us wait till he comes. Well, God save you. I thank you. How do you do? So-so, indifferently. Where have you been? And where have you come from? Out of town. Which way went did you go? I went through the doorway. Where will you go? Homeward. And where will you go from there? Nowhere. Where have you, when have you been in the garden? Yesterday, today, some time ago, recently, long ago. When will you visit me? By and by, tomorrow, the day after, sometime or other. Do you know the lesson by heart? So-so. I, not at all. Not at all. Why? What, have you forgotten? Almost. Why don't you repeat it? I don't have time now. How come? I have to go into town. Truly, I will go together with you. No. Why not? We can repeat on our journey. That is better than chatting. Not at all. Will we return soon? Possibly, but hardly. Oh, do you doubt? It's far away. We will hurry. As cobblers, what then? Nimbleness, speediness becomes is fitting for our age. So they say, yes, that's true. Don't cry, but we are not alone. How shall we play? At ball. For how long? All day long. That's too much. But they are holidays. Prepositions. Let us go on, I beg you. Now I will explain the small words to you. We draw towards us, we push away from us. We lead with us, we drive in front of us, we snatch behind us. It is easy to swim with the stream of water. Against it, it's impossible. The priest at the altar has his deacon attending to him. Regarding somebody who is rash, take care that he does not stay inside the house. Let him climb over the top. Let him creep with up to the threshold. Confess in front of us what you have done privately, hidden from us, because it is clear. I have done against the command. I have been unthankful towards the teacher. Someone, because of his wickedness, being a runaway from the house, running by the road, stood on the side of the pool. Afterwards, having gone beyond the pool, he came into the wilderness. He went about in the marshes, he wandered among the woods. He sailed beyond the sea, even to the furthest islands, right to the end of the world, wandering out of the country. For whom they beg mercy, but because of the examples of others, he cannot be received back. Alas, how great a mishap. He is happy in comparison of such a one who keeps his conscience pure. Numbers. Do you know how to count? Very well. Try then. How many are these things? One is the book of the Bible. Two are the testaments, old and new. Three persons of the Holy Trinity. Four evangelists. Five senses. Six working days. Seven petitions in the Lord's Prayer, or 7 days are a week. Three threes are nine. 10 commandments of God. 11 apostles, Judas not being counted. 12 articles of faith. 30 days are a month. 100 years are a century. And Satan is the forger of 1,000 deceits. Chapter 4. Regarding things in school. A scholar hangs out in the school that he may be instructed in the arts. The beginning is from the letters. Words are made of syllables. A speech is made of words. We read silently out of a book, or we recite it aloud. We wrap it up in a cover. We lay it on a desk. Ink is in the inkwell in which we dip the pen. We write with it on paper, on either page. If we make a mistake, we blot it out. And then we mark it above the line or in the margin. A teacher teaches, a scholar learns, not everything at once, but bit by bit. A teacher commands things to be done, and the headmaster rules the school. The tutor watches, and he encourages. The prefect warns and writes down. The teacher instructs everyone together, and they pay attention individually. He corrects mistakes. The one who works hard profits, and the one who is negligent is hit. For the rod is close by. They don't beat with a staff, but they do beat with rods. Do not go out without permission, and come back after a delay, and do what you need to do. A line is made with a ruler, a circle by a set of compasses. A grammarian speaks, a logician argues. Somebody that tells truth from falsehood, a rhetorician speaks elegantly, a musician sings, a poet makes verses, a painter paints images, an historian tells of things done. A philosopher searches out nature, a doctor imitates it. A moralist shows manners, which are suitable for a virtuous man, but of them a little lower down. Chapter 5. Of Things at Home. Knock at the door if the door is shut, or knock at the doors if they are shut. When the door is opened, cross the threshold and go into the courtyard. A key locks a lock and unlocks it again. A nail is fastened. We walk on the floor. The roof or the ceiling is suspended over us. The windows are made of glass. The living room is warmed, but the other rooms are cold. We hide things in chests and in coffers and in cupboards. We carry in baskets. Juice is not kept in a bag. There are beds in a bedroom covered with cupboards. We put a pillow under the neck. We cover ourselves with coverlets, with blankets, lying on the face up, lying with face upward or face downward, supine or prone. A chamber pot is for urine, and a toilet is for easing the belly. Excrement smells bad. We perfume it with the spice frankincense. We wash our face daily. We sweat in a bath. We cleanse ourselves with cloths. A barber cuts hair. He combs the hair with a comb. Spots, dirt spots, are wiped out with a sponge. And sweepings on the floor are swept away with brooms. We put a shirt on and off, and a coat and a doublet and breeches, and also our socks. As often as we need, we put on a cloak and a gown. Caps and collars, gloves and sandals are for credit's sake. We tie ourselves round with a belt, and we cover a table with a tablecloth. A spoon is for soup or for porridge. Other foods are eaten with a knife. We drive away flies with a fly swat. Take away the covers and pour into the cup. And toast the guests. Light a candle and then the candlestick. Snuff it out with snuffers, but do not blow it out. A man and woman are partners. A widower sometimes marries a virgin. A bridegroom has a bride. After the marriage, a husband has a wife. In childbed, a woman brings forth a child. A nurse kisses him and hugs him in her lap. The son is an heir, the daughter gets a dowry. Parents bring up their issue, that's their offspring. A stepfather and a stepmother bring up their stepchildren. Children are free, servants serve. Household attendants do household service. Maidservants also serve. An uncle and an aunt, called patrus and amita, are the father's brother and mother, and sister. And avunculus and matertera, the mothers. Grandfathers have what are called nephews. Kinsmen are kindred, they are relations by marriage. Chapter 6. Regarding things in the city and in the area. A city is fortified with walls, and also with a trench and a ditch. The door has got, the gate that is, has got folding doors, and from there we enter into the streets. There are wells or cisterns, which are accustomed to be in the marketplace. Buildings are public or they are private, for what is not belonging to one is common. Citizens and inhabitants inhabit a city, and agricultural people, rustic people, live in the village. Neighbours in the same vicinity. The Senate gathers in the court, the consul goes in front, and the senators follow. The judge judges cases in law. The pleader accuses the offender of a crime, and the accused excuses himself. A witness witnesses and swears, and the police officer ties him up and carries him to prison, and the executioner hangs and kills him. A letter carrier carries letters sealed with wax and a seal. A messenger tells the news face to face. A temple is a holy place. A tavern is a secular or profane one. The sexton rings the bells. The people meet in the church and do their religious duties. Psalms and hymns are sung in the assembly of the people. The word of God is preached and the sacraments are administered. Prayers are performed devoutly. Feasts are celebrated festively. A magistrate is necessary that a king may reign in his kingdom. But let a lord rule at home. Let those who rule be merciful, those who obey obedient. An honest master is approved, as is also a faithful subject. A prince is of lower status than a duke, an earl is greater than a baron, a nobleman, a knight who is ennobled with titles of honour. Peace is altogether to be wished. War is hurtful, unless when an enemy is to be driven away. Soldiers serve for wages when they fight and battle. The trumpets sound, the drums sound. They shoot arrows out of bows. They fight with swords. They defend themselves with weapons. They beat down towers with cannons. They return with victory. Chapter 7, the final chapter. Regarding virtues, follow the virtues. Shun vice, which the law forbids. Somebody that does wickedness is mischievous or naughty. That you may be wise, take care or look to the end. Look at the means and attend to the occasion. Begin nothing rashly and think long and hasten slowly. Do not believe a rumor, do not tell a secret. Do not affirm or deny something which you know nothing about. Rather, ask. Be temperate, that means be moderate. When you are hungry, eat. When you are thirsty, drink. Gluttons eat and drink greedily. Let dinner and supper be enough for you. Do not pay attention to breakfast and brunch. Sometimes it is useful to fast. A sober person is not drunk. Be chaste. Carry yourself modestly. Also, be self-contained. Do not babble. Be silent. Do not just talk on endlessly. Young men, you should cultivate the old man. Tell things that are clear. Mutter out a secret and conceal things that are hidden. When someone speaks, hold your tongue. When he says something to you, listen. When he commands something, obey. Do not boast of yourself and don't be arrogant or proud. Having a good reputation is a great glory. It is quite lawful to love it, and it is unlawful to despise it. Be gentle to everyone, flattering to no one. A flatterer is disgusting. It is allowed sometimes to joke, but politely. It is also allowed to laugh, but not to giggle unreasonably. We vex in jest, we rebuke seriously. We check any way necessary. A thrifty person is content with a few things. A greedy person is sparing, let's say a miser is sparing, and a liberal person gives away freely. A foolish person trusts God when he has lots, but he distrusts him when he doesn't have. A just person desires nothing from anybody else. It is dishonest to steal. Lend which anyone requires. Restore which you have borrowed. Perform which you have promised. And when you don't have, let it not irk you to ask. When it is given, don't be ashamed to take it. And when you have got it, say thank you. Let a thief pay for his theft, or let him hang from the gallows. Indeed, he is worthy of punishment. A gift is given freely, a reward for a good turn. Wages for merit. A man of weak spirit is not strong. He is puffed up when he is prosperous, and he trembles when things don't go his way. Be energetic in your labors. Leave idleness to the lazy. If you will try something, then you ought first to check it out. Then you should set upon the matter, and don't delay any more. Fortune is unconstant, and it brings miserable chances, which a patient man suffers, although he mourn and weep and lament. Keep in your anger, and spare an offender, and pardon somebody that begs. Has anyone hurt you? Forgive him the fault. Have you offended anyone? Then you should appease and you should quiet him. It is better to bear injuries than to revenge them. A malicious person curses, a foolish person threatens. Be obedient to your superiors, courteous to your equals, gentle to your inferiors, and you should be amiable, that's friendly, to everybody. Whoever is courteous, then he says hello to those people he meets. And he also greets those that greet him, and answers those that ask, and gives those that request, and helps the needy, and comforts the sad, and informs or educates the ignorant, and advises those that stand in need of advice. He envies nobody and favors everybody. A true person studies for truth. A liar lies. A friend loves, an enemy hates. A crafty person deceives, and a sincere person does not. A companion helps, a partner works with one, and a friend is a companion. The conclusion. Do many things remain? Few, I think. See the last title. For this gateway is only a beginning, which is not suitable to be full of words. We have arrived at the end. Life passes like a shadow. Whatever is born dies. All things are vain. O sinner, death will eat you up. Then, at last, you will go into the grave, and out of the light, into darkness. You, therefore, whoever you are, fear hell, desire heaven, sin not, lest you perish. Here we are, neither do we add any more. Reader, be contented. You shall find everything else arranged in order when you enter the gate. And the gate, of course, is the next book in the series by Comenius. Then pray in this way. Grant us knowledge, grant us godliness, grant us blessedness. And that's the end of the Vestibulum, read through in English. Vale, bye. It contains, about 1,000 words in Latin.